हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। एज पर द सिलेबस प्रिस्क्राइब्ड बाय द वेस यूनिवर्सिटी बड़ौरी एंड द पेपर 6.1 वी हैव स्टडी मेनली द स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी एंड द स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी वी हैव स्टडी थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट स्पेक्ट्रास। नंबर वन इज रोटेशनल स्पेक्ट्रा, सेकेंड वन इज वाइब्रेशन स्पेक्ट्रा एंड द थर्ड वन इज रामन स्पेक्ट्रा। ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फर्स्ट स्पेक्ट्रा दैट इज कॉल्ड एज रोटेशनल स्पेक्ट्रा बाय टेकिंग एग्जांपल ऑफ रेसिप्रोकेटर एज वेल एज नॉन रेसिप्रोकेटर। व्हेरएज बट स्टिल डिस्कस अबाउट द वाइब्रेशन स्पेक्ट्रा। यस, रिगार्डिंग वाइब्रेशन स्पेक्ट्रा the first and the foremost important thing to get the vibration spectra is like this. To get the vibration spectra, the basic criteria is mainly to get the vibration spectra, it is observed in the IR region, that is 100 micrometer to 1 micrometer wavelength. That is the first basic criteria to get the vibration spectra. And secondly, the second basic criteria to get the vibration spectra is the molecule must show change in change in dipole moment. Change in dipole moment during vibration. Look here, these are the important criteria, basic criteria to get the IR spectra. Number one is it must fall in the IR region, that is 100 micrometer to 1 micrometer wavelength. And second one is the molecule show change in dipole moment during its change. So these are two important basic criteria to get the IR spectra. And as per the syllabus, under this IR spectra, already got as vibration spectra, you have to study two important things. One is vibration spectra of simple harmonic oscillator in case of a diatomic molecule. Yes, let us see how to get the spectra in case of vibration spectra of simple harmonic oscillator by taking a diatomic molecule. Yes, let us take a diatomic molecule. Look here, when the molecule is in normal state, let's look at the diagram number one. The molecule is in the normal state. In the diagram number two, the molecule is structured. And here, when the molecule is structured and by leaving this one, it is undergoing vibration and it restores to its original state. And this kind of model is called as a simple harmonic oscillator model. According to Hooke's law, the restored force, that means the molecule after a number of vibrations, it comes back to its original state. And its force is given by minus of K into R minus of Re, where R is the distance to which the molecule has been structured. Whereas Re is the bond distance between two atoms when the molecule is in the normal state. This Re is the bond distance when the molecule is in the normal state, whereas R is the bond distance when the molecule is structured. And that displacement is given by Re minus R, that is called as displacement. According to Hooke's law, the restored force F is equal to minus K into displacement, that is called R minus of Re. And look here, this R minus R is equal to X, therefore F is equal to minus of K into X. This is according to Hooke's law. And for this model, its production is given by E is equal to half into K into X square, where K is called as the force constant. K is called as force constant and X is the displacement. And this model of a vibrating molecule is called as a simple harmonic oscillator model. It is called as SHO, simple harmonic oscillator model. And here, for this model, when a molecule is vibrating, it is at some frequency. Therefore, oscillation frequency of a simple harmonic oscillator known by omega oscillation, whereas in case of red spectrum, by using the rotation, is called as mu, is called as frequency. But here, we are changing the term from nu to omega. So, omega is the amount of oscillation frequency. So, omega oscillation is equal to 1 upon 2 pi in the square root of A by 2, that is in terms of Hertz. You call it as equation number 3. Where mu is called reduced mass of molecule. And converting this frequency into mu number, simply when frequency is divided by c, velocity of light, then this term is called as mu 1. Called as real number. But in this case, when equation number 3 is divided by C, you get omega more oscillation. That is anything but real number. Real number is the better spectroscopic unit. Therefore, omega more oscillation real number is equal to 1 upon 2 by C in the square root of A by mu, that is in terms of 1 centimeter. Okay. So, for this kind of molecule, when a molecule undergoing a number of vibrations and is experiencing some energy, and according to Schrodinger equation, for allowed vibration energies, the energy is given by EV is equal to V plus of H into omega oscillation. That is in terms of Joules. Okay, called as equation number 5. And V is called vibrational quantum. Then dividing equation number 5 on both sides by Hc, we are getting Ev by Hc is equal to Ev, that is equal to V plus half by C into omega oscillation. And this term omega oscillation by C is called as omega bar oscillation. Therefore, Ev is equal to V plus half omega bar oscillation, that is in terms of bar centimeter. Okay. And look here, by putting the values of V is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this, we are getting different energy levels. Suppose first, when V is equal to 0, EV is E0 is equal to 1 half into omega bar oscillation. Suppose by putting the value of V is equal to 1, E1, that is energy the first level, is equal to 3 by 2 into omega bar oscillation. Suppose when V is equal to 2, E2, that is energy in the second level, is given by 5 by 2 into omega bar oscillation. Suppose when V is equal to 4, means E4, that is energy in the fourth level, is equal to 9 by 2 into omega bar oscillation. Like this, we are getting different energy levels. That is simply it is written in the fashion of, in the terms of diagram like this. That is, by putting a graph of intermolecular distance versus energy, we are getting different energy levels. And look here, the energy levels are equally spaced. Equally spaced. Suppose when V is equal to 0, that means E0 is equal to 1 half into omega bar oscillation. Omega bar oscillation. And look here, when V is equal to 0, means energy in the lowest vibration level. And this kind of energy is called as 0 point energy. That is simply recognized ZPE, 0 point energy. And let us see what is the meaning of ZPE, that is 0 point energy. 0 point energy is what? Energy in the lowest vibrational state. Energy in the lowest vibrational state is called 0 point energy. Okay, it's all about the vibrant spectrum of simple harmonic oscillator. Okay, and next hour we'll discuss about how we are getting the spectral lines by approximation to spectral lines. Okay, thank you. Yes, after knowing the energy levels, how energy levels are observed in case of vibrant spectral simple harmonic oscillator, and let us go through the spectrum. How the spectrum is observed in case of simple harmonic oscillator? Yes, sir. To get the spectrum, the molecule has to go either from lower level to higher level or from higher level to lower level. And we have to follow some rules. This is called as a selection rule. The selection rule in case of vibrant spectra for a simple harmonic oscillator is given by this delta is equal to plus or minus 1. Suppose if delta is equal to plus 1, that corresponds to absorption. That means when a molecule is absorbing certain radiation and it goes to high energy level, in a different energy level, that is equal to plus 1. Similarly, when delta is equal to minus 1, that corresponds to emission. That means the molecule is jumping from higher level to lower level. Suppose for absorption delta is equal to plus 1, then transient takes place from V to V plus 1. V is the lower energy level, V plus 1 is higher energy level, and difference is only plus 1. V to V plus 1. Then the spectrum is obtained. By using this selection rule, its energy difference is given by delta E is equal to E V plus 1 minus of E V. In the energy expression, by having the expression that is given by E V is equal to V plus half into omega bar oscillation. Substituting the value of V is equal to V plus 1, we are getting V plus 1 plus half omega bar oscillation, that is for V plus 1 level. Minus half casual E is equal to V plus half into omega bar oscillation. And by simplifying this one, we are getting the nth difference sigma by delta E is equal to omega bar oscillation. Similarly, for emission, whenever a molecule is undergoing transition from higher level to lower level, that is given by V plus 1 level to V level. And its energy difference is given by, that is delta EV. Delta EV is equal to, in the reverse order, the final level is EV, and initial level is V plus 1, that is EV minus of EV plus 1, that is by taking the same values in a different manner, creating V plus of into omega oscillation minus of this much. And again, difference is same with an negative sign. This is given by EV is equal to minus of omega oscillation. That shows that either the molecule is going from lower level to higher level or from higher level to lower level, we are getting only one line. Board line is open like this. Say for example, for transition between 0 to 1 level, 0 to 1 level, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. Like this, sir. Whenever molecules are undergoing transition from lower level to higher level, or in the reverse manner, it is from 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to, like this, sir. 1 to 0. Again, we are getting the same one line. Board line is open. And this line is called as the fundamental frequency. So this is all about how the spectral lines are observed in case of the vibrant spectra of simple harmonic oscillator. Only one line is obtained with the value of omega bar oscillation, and this frequency is called as the fundamental frequency. Like this, the lines are observed in the IR spectra of simple harmonic oscillator.